You are good and I dance because you are good and I shout because you are good. Tell him this morning, how's it the Lord been so good to you? Oh, you are so at you. You are better. You're better than all of the drugs put together. Oh, you're the only one that came into my heart and blew it up.
Somebody tell me that this morning.
Oh, you, and you are better. You're better than all of the drugs put together. I'm crazy in love with you and me, created by you, you, yes, I'm head over heels for you. If I'm out of my mind, it's you, cause I'm crazy in love with you and me, created by you, you,
yes, I'm head over heels for you.
Your love makes my heart beat to the rhythm.
rhythm of an 80s love song. Your love makes my heart move. And your love makes my heart beat to the rhythm of an 80s love song. Your love makes my heart move. I see your love throws me around and around like a wild bull when the rodeo comes to town. And when your joy, oh, when your joy it hits me, I start moving and shaking and dancing like a gypsy. Oh, when your love throws me around and around like a wild boar when the rodeo comes to town. And when your joy, oh, hits me, when it hits me, I start moving and shaking and dancing like a gypsy. If I'm out of my mind, it's you, cause I'm crazy in love with you and me, created by you, you, yes, I'm over here. lost in joy this morning. Oh, oh, let everything else just pass away, God. Let us get lost in you. Lost in the rhythm of you. Lost in the rhythm of your love. Let that rhythm draw us out. Let it draw us out this morning.
We haven't seen until we've seen him filled with joy. We haven't seen him till we've seen him filled with joy. We haven't known him till we've known him filled with joy. We haven't known him till we've known him filled with joy.
Thank you. just want to bless your name. And I just want to make you glad. And I just want to move your heart, God, to give you all I am. And I just want to bless your name. And I just want to make you glad. And I just want to move your heart, God, to give you all I am. Sing that again. I just want to bless your name. And I just want to bless your name. I just want to make you glad. And I just want to move your heart, God, to give you all I have. I just want to bless your name. And I just want to bless your name. And I just want to make you. And I just want to move your heart, God, to give you all I am. It's by your worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you.
Jesus.
Oh. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. Sing it out to him. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. You are holy, God. You are righteous in all your ways, and you are good. Oh, when we join with the angels, when we join with the seraphim, and we say to our holy God, to our holy God, we join with all of creation. We declare that you are worthy, you are wonderful, you are worthy, you are wonderful, you are worthy, you are wonderful. blessings flow, and we praise God. From whom all blessings flow, we praise you. And we praise God. From whom all blessings flow. Blessings flow, and we praise God. From whom all blessings flow, and we praise God. From whom all blessings flow. And we praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
We adore you.
And we praise. Blessings flow, and we praise God. From all blessings flow, and we praise God. From all blessings flow, He's worthy. With honor and glory and power and might and men. He's worthy of glory and honor and power and might. Forever and ever.
How could I comprehend a beautiful beauty that it has no end. He's beckoned us to come and see. And every nation testifies your majesty, they can't deny. Your son has made a way for them to come.
Thank you, Jesus. For this lady here, the Lord said the time is now. This is the time. It's an urgent time. The time is now. It's an urgent time, particularly going out two by two, saving lives, going to emergency situations, being led by the Holy Spirit. Time to go. You're going to be special ops for the Lord to save lives, to rescue people, and to bring them into the kingdom of God, to bring them into the river. The time is now, and you are ready. Quickly, quickly, when the Lord says go, you go. You go. Could I have the Alabama minstrel? I want to prophesy, if it's okay, for you and your wife, sir.
Hope, your shirt. See, there's feedback because part of the outreach requires feeding and giving back to the community. But also, her shirt, for those of you who don't see, it says, Hope Lives Here. And see, hope is more than your name. It's also your calling. It's not just a name on your driver's license. It's actually the blood in your veins. So, Father, we We receive hope. Just all across this room, I'm not talking about just receiving an individual. We know that God gave gifts to men in the form of men and women in grace. But I'm telling you, hope lives here. Hope lives where you are because of Christ in you. The unfailing hope of glory. Amen? So just all across the room, declare and decree with your mouth. Say, hope lives here. Hope lives here. You see, when we first came to Birmingham, the Lord spoke to our heart. He was looking for houses. The Lord Jesus was looking for houses to call home. And I want to tell you this morning that in your house and in this house, He has found a resting place. Amen?
Thank you. Sean. Sean. Come and help me, Sean. Give that man a guitar or something. Want the song of the Lord, Sean. So, yes, there's all sorts of stuff going to happen, but I think the Lord wants to change your name again. You got many names. The Lord's got many names. So, how do you pronounce it?
Your surname? Hooper.
Hooper! Super Hooper! Well, it's not Superman. It's not even Hooperman. But the Lord has shown me that when you look at this guy, you say, wow, W-O-W, take away the O-W, put the W in front of the Hooper, and you got Whooper. You know what a Whooper is? A Whooper is a big swan. A Whooper is the heaviest, one of the heaviest birds on the earth. Heavy anointing. The heavy anointing on the swan. But the big thing about the Hooper swans, they're made for life. They're made for life for generations and generations and generations. And one thing about the Hooper swan, when they're ready to move, the mate keeps looking for the other one. And if the wife isn't looking, he's not going anywhere. They keep nodding with their head. He keeps watching his signals from the wife. And if the wife isn't gone, he isn't going anywhere. The Lord's doing a new thing with you. This is a new thing the Lord's doing with you. This is family He's doing with you. You're going to talk about money this morning, and the biggest money robber in this nation is divorce. The biggest thing that takes money out of families and out of businesses and out of this nation is divorce. And there shall be no divorce. You are married for life like the Hooper swans. Like the Hooper swans. And Hooper swans, they need lots of water because they're big. They need lots of water. Lots of the Holy Spirit. Lots of the move of God. Not just one move. Not just one stream. Not just one river. They need lots and lots of water. Lots and lots of water. And lots of their great flyers as well. When they fly, they know how to fly. And they can move. They can move crowds of people. Hooper swans. White Hooper swans. They love the Hooper swans in Europe, by the way. I don't know what they like them over here, but in Europe, we love those Hooper swans. The Spirit of the Lord is upon you, like He has been on many people and many prophets in this nation. But the Spirit of Elijah is upon you. That's the difficulty. That's the pain. That's what you will carry. That's what will make the difference. That's what will bring permanence. The Spirit of Elijah. Yeah. To turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the hearts of the children to the fathers. And you're not like the other fathers. This is a different thing here. There's opportunity. It's a day of opportunity. So there will be breakthrough. This man will bring breakthrough. But he needs to keep watching the other swan. He needs to keep looking for the signals. If she's not looking your direction, don't fly. If she's not giving you the nod, don't go. Two are better than one. Yeah. We were in your office this morning and we saw the horse, but there was one at the side. This is the one at your side. This is the one at your side. This is the one to look to. This is the one to look to. There shall be no divorce. There shall be faithfulness and permanence. And you shall be a happy mother of children and a happy grandmother of children. mothers and fathers in the nation. Keep watching her. If mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. If mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. And we bless the fruit of your womb. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord and who walks in his ways. You shall eat of the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be happy and it shall be well with you. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house, and your children will be like olive shoots around your table. This shall a man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. And Zion's going to be a big deal for you. Jerusalem's going to be a big deal for you. You will bring many people to Jerusalem. You will get much revelation at Jerusalem. But this is your portion. This woman is a swan that God has put beside you. Watch her signals. Listen to her. Listen to her heartbeat. Bless her. That has not happened. Too many people have went somewhere else and everything's taken away. Nobody loves you like her. Nobody will stay with you like her. Nobody will put up with you like her. Nobody will pray for you like her. Nobody will be with you like her. When the whole battlefield's over, she will be standing with you. And there will be good days and bad days. This is a battle that you're going for. You were not born for days of peace. You were born for war. And those horses are war horses. You're going into the battle because you're going to take a lot of territory for the kingdom of God. But it's going to be for families.
Yeah.
The spirit of Elijah is upon you. For you will turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the children to the fathers. And God has shown me, unlike other prophetic people, Jesus talked about that he would send prophets and wise men and scribes. You're going to have wise men with you. You're going to be open to the wise men. And the wise men are going to be open to you. And the scribes are going to write it down. You're going to cause much writing. There'll be writing this morning, but you will cause books to be written. You will release the testimony of Jesus in different nations and in this nation. But it shall be for families. Family, Hooper swans mate for life. Hooper swans mate for life. Plenty of water, plenty of wind, plenty of movement, plenty of everything, but they mate for life. I break the power of divorce over you and over your people. No divorce in ministry, no divorce in the families. You will bring restoration, not divorce. You will bring them together. Unity. Unity and love, that people may grow and it may continue for one generation to the next generation to the next generation. There is no shortcut for what God is doing in your life. You're not just a politician. You're a statesman. You need to look down the generations. Look not to this generation, the next. You're doing, the Lord's giving you an opportunity to do something that will be permanent in his kingdom, something of significance. And does it look like it might happen? Of course it doesn't. Doesn't he look like everybody else? He looks like some of those other guys. But he's not, because he's got a father's heart. A father's heart who loves his wife and children. And that's what he's going to lay down his life for. The children, 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 the children.
There is this longing for that still small voice. Just as Elijah heard that still small voice, you will hear, you will see, you will be in that place, that place. And there is a longing in you, not just for this to be yours, for you to bring others with you, to bring your family into the presence of the Lord. Intimacy, intimacy. You will train others to see, and a place of intimacy, a place of nearness to the Lord, of even hiddenness with Him, of nearness to the Lord, of closeness to His heart. Intimacy, intimacy with the fire of Elijah. Intimacy and closeness to the Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we bless this man and this woman and this family and these children and this child unborn, Father. Thank you, Lord, you're doing a new thing. Lord, give them holidays. Give them memories and times together, Father. Let them do a new thing. Let them be examples to all the flock, Lord, of the goodness of God in the land of the living. Jesus, we bless you, Tina. We bless you, Tina. We bless you, Tina. It's not easy. It is not easy. You were created and made for these days. We proclaim God's favor upon you and true friendship upon you. Friends who will love you. Blessed amongst women. Let her be blessed amongst women. Bless her amongst women.
Father, we just, Lord, we ask that this, Lord, that what was released here would begin to travel the bloodlines of each and every relationship that's connected to this place and connected to this ministry. We speak into the marriage of fathers and children to be strengthened. We speak reuniting. In fact, just take the hand of your spouse all across the room right now. And there's some marriages right now that we're believing for restoration outside of this place, but have inheritance here. I'm just going to come down there with you because I want to hold Tina's hand while we do this. But we speak to the north. We speak to the south. We speak to the east and we speak to the west. We speak to the winds of adversity to give up the spouses that have been taken away. God, we speak of reconciliation throughout your body. Lord, that not one more marriage would be lost due to ministry. And Father, right now, we set a standard in this house for for this house and for the ministries represented here, that the mistress of ministry would be kicked out of the bed of marriage. That ministry would not be the foundation of marriage, but marriage would be the foundation of ministry. God, reunite the marriages of our fathers. Bring reconciliation and a turning of the heart. You know, and I don't like putting anybody else's business on Front Street, but since it's already on the internet, it is. Father, right now as a house, we just stand for reconciliation with Paul, Keith, and Wanda. We call them together as one, and no man will separate. We call them as one, even this day, in Jesus' name. Lord, and even into other ministries, Lord, that, Lord, we've seen in times past where there hasn't been an equal yoking to be able to move forward in the things of the Lord, to where you almost looked at a spouse as a liability instead as an ally. Lord, right now we speak, Lord, that the root of pride, Lord, that would begin to give way to that thought process, that it'd be rooted out of the hearts of man. And Lord, that you would begin to turn the eyes, the ears, and the heart of each and every family here and those connected to this place and throughout your body. Lord, that you would turn their hearts and their focus to their home. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now give your spouse a big old kiss. Come on now. Give them a great big hug. Give them a kiss. Don't look at me. Come on now. Listen, a good kiss can be warfare well fought. Kissing them. Hey, listen, we can take it to a whole nother level. Partnering with the promise is a whole different level of warfare. When you don't want to look at your spouse, chances are you need to lay with your spouse. Chances are you need, when the enemy's trying to come in and divide, you need to say, we're going to do whatever it takes to come together. Amen? And I'll let you just go on with that. Hey, listen, let's thank the Lord for Brendan McCauley. And let's go ahead and bring all the kids up.